No guns for village watchmen, enforcing quarantine curfews in the Philippines. The order issued by the National Police Chief after an alleged quarantine violator, Eduardo Genyoga, was fatally shot by a village watchman in Manila last weekend. The police are investigating the incident. Genyoga's family is appealing for help in covering his funeral expenses.
Yung anong problema namin, yung pinansya ng pangailangan kasi walang-wala rin kami. Pangdamit nga niya, wala eh. Tapos yung pangbayad pa sa doon sa pinagdala ng ano, bangkay. Tinataga rin ho kami sa presyo eh. Bali, 15,000 ang sinisingil namin, sinisingil sa amin. Tapos nagdagdag pa ng 9,000. Kaya hindi namin mailabas.
The Commission on Human Rights has started an investigation into this latest shooting. It condemns the incident, asserting the pandemic is a health crisis and not a peace and order agenda. The CHR also reminding authorities to adhere to human rights-based policing. The City of Manila set to begin the distribution of lockdown aid today, along with other local government units in Metro Manila. The development comes after Manila Mayor Isko Moreno was reportedly summoned to the headquarters of the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority Tuesday evening. A source told ABS-CBN News Moreno met with various cabinet officials to discuss President Rodrigo Duterte's directives on the distribution of cash aid in his city. Duterte earlier wanted the Interior Department to handle the disbursement of aid in a certain Metro Manila city, calling the mayor disorganized.
Maraming salamat kay Pangulong Duterte, sa DSWD, sa DILG, at sa Department of National Defense. Masayang-masaya po ako na mabibigay na ang ayuda. Handa na po. Ngunit, mga kababayan, ha, makisuyo lang. Ha, mag-behave tayo.
Meanwhile, Interior Undersecretary Ipimaco Den Singh III says they are still ready to step in anytime.
There's a need for the DILG and the DSWD to step in. Pagdapatunayan po natin hindi maayos ang pagbabahagi at magulo po ang pagbabahagi ng ayuda at nabaviolate po yung mga minimum public health protocols, pwede naman ho manghimasok o pumasok ang ibang ahensya ng gobyerno para itama yung mga pagkakamaling pagdidistribute o pagbabahagi ng ayuda.
A political party accuses President Duterte of politicizing the government's pandemic aid distribution. The Aksyon Demokratiko, where Isko Moreno was supposed to take his oath last week, slammed Duterte for his recent snide remarks, which seemed to be directed at the Manila mayor. The party says Duterte should just focus on responding to the COVID crisis and not on the upcoming 2022 national elections.
Yung kanyang pagyurak doon sa personalidad nung tinutukoy niya po, no, ang alam namin eh si Mayor Isko Moreno nga masyado namang below the belt. Bakit namumuliti ka sa panahon ng pandemya? I think kasi pagka sinabi mo na tinatanggalan mo siya ng karapatan na dahil disorganisado siya na mamahagi para sa kanyang nasasakupan, parang sinasabi mo rin na sa mga tao, sa taong bayan generally, na nako, napakahina, napakapalpak ng taong yon. Na sabi ko nga po, kabaligtaran naman na sinasabi ng dalawang ahensya ng pamahalaan.
Cabinet Secretary Carlo Nograles is pushing to digitalize the distribution of COVID-19 aid during the hard lockdown in Metro Manila. Nograles says it shouldn't be a problem for local government units since they have easy access to banks and remittance centers. Several e-wallet platforms were already used to provide assistance during the lockdowns last year.
The Philippines logged some 8,500 new COVID infections Tuesday, raising the nationwide tally to around 1,676,000. 92 more people also died. Active cases now stand at 79,000, the highest since April 24th. The country's positivity rate has meanwhile reached a more than four-month high of 21.9%. The World Health Organization says a positivity rate of below 5% is one of the indications infections are under control. Local health officials admitting government needs to ramp up testing by about 3 times more than the average.
If we can reach about more than 80 to 90,000 tests per day, mas magiging makabuluhan at makikita natin yung complete picture ng mga nagkakasakit dito sa ating bansa.